What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, and today I want to make a video talking about boost jumping. Now, boost jumping is a very controversial topic in the Call of Duty community because most people hate it, but there is a small community of people that actually enjoy boost jumping. This small community of people just prefers their games more bouncy, fast-paced, and that's totally reasonable, and I don't hate you if you are pro boost jumping. Personally, I'm not a fan, and I wanted to talk about a common argument that pro boost jumpers will suggest, and that is that boost jumping adds skill to Call of Duty. It adds a layer of skill that wasn't there before, and thus, you know, it makes the game harder to play for the average player because it's an additional skill that you have to know and take into account. Little bit of a spoiler, I'm going to go right ahead and say boost jumping adds a tiny bit of skill. However, it brings a lot more negatives to the table that make it just not worth it in my opinion. And with that being said, let's get right into the video. So first, I think it's important we talk about why do people hate boost jumping? You know, a lot of people are just hating boost jumping. Well, let's talk about why people hate it, you know, and I think there's two main reasons. And the first one, which is very minor, and that is that people can get around the map a lot faster with boost jumping. You know, with boost jumping comes boost sliding and wall running and all this other stuff, you know, and you could double jump into windows that previously would only be accessible through going around the building, through the door, up the stairs, and things along those lines. So people can just get around a lot faster, and by the way, I think that's why this new hijacked map, Skyjacked, is fucking garbage, dude. Boost jumping ruined that shit. So yeah, with boost jumping, people just move around the map faster, and thus spawns flip, and the location of the enemy is a little bit harder to track. You know, it's sometimes they'll just seem to spawn behind you, even though you just killed them, and that's because spawns are flipping, people are moving all over the place, and the game has to keep track of where people can safely spawn, and that is changing a lot more frequently because people can move very quickly around the map. And I think, you know, with that comes a little bit more randomness. It doesn't make it harder to predict where enemies are coming from. It just makes it that they're coming from more areas, so it's just you know, a little bit more random with boost jumping involved and the speed with which players can get around all sorts of areas of the map. The second reason I think people hate boost jumping, and this is the major one, is that it causes them to lose gunfights that they should have won. And for example, if you're in a one man versus one man gunfight and you're firing and you are going to win the gunfight, the enemy player can now double jump, and if you don't anticipate that, or you can't follow them through the air at whatever direction they randomly chose to go, they could win the gunfight because they already know what direction they're going and they know where to follow you. So in order to counter that, right, you have to now boost slide forward or back up to be able to see into the sky where they were. And the reason that's so important is because when they boost jumped, they went off your screen. If you're close enough to an enemy and they boost jump off of your screen because screens are wider than they are tall. And that's because humans, actual human beings, our eyes see more in a, you know, in a landscape view than we do in a portrait view. We just simply see more in this way than we do in this way. That's just how the human brain and the human eyes are built. So it's only natural that, you know, screens are the same. You know, we don't want things to be too far out of our field of view, so screens are just wider than they are tall. Thus, when you add a vertical movement to a game like Call of Duty, they go off your screen. They just go off the screen. So in order to actually continue that gunfight, you now have to boost forward or back up and look up into the sky and try and find them because they're no longer on your screen, and therefore you might not get that kill anymore because they seem to just vanish. And I think this is the big reason why people hate boost jumping. You know, it's kind of unfair. In the past Call of Duties, you only had to worry about your enemy either going behind a head glitch, going around a corner completely to where you can't fire at them, or drop shotting. That was another thing that you had to take into account. Those are the only things you had to worry about, and in all of those scenarios, your enemy pretty much stays on your screen. If you're really close to an enemy and they drop shot you, yes, they do go below the screen, but they're only moving a matter of 5.5-6 feet, as opposed to boost jumping where you jump like three character lengths. So it's a huge difference, and in general, the older Call of Duties, if you're firing at somebody, they're either going to go around a building or they'll be on your screen somewhere to shoot at. And with boost jumping, that's simply not the case anymore. So now that we've talked about why people actually hate boost jumping, let's objectively talk about what makes boost jumping a skill. So we're gonna go through a few tests to see if boost jumping is actually a skill, right? Because skills are something that, you know, you have to learn how to do. So let's look at that, at boost jumping as a skill. First off, is boost jumping something that only some players can do once they've learned how to do it? The answer is no. All you have to do is press the X or A button and you boost jump. G sliding, on the other hand, is a skill because you have to learn the timing of the G slide, you have to learn when to use it, what parts of the map, how far you're gonna go, and things along those lines. So G sliding, in my book, is a skill because you have to learn how to do it and you have to learn when it's applicable and when the time is right to G slide. Boost jumping is not a skill. Every player who picks up a controller for Black Ops 3 can boost jump without really being taught. You just press the button and you just boost jump, so it's totally not a skill. Every player who you find in Black Ops 3 can and will be boost jumping. The next thing I want to talk about is whether or not boost jumping brings the player to an advantageous location on the map. And there's two parts to this, right? And I need you to focus and I need you to pay attention and hear what I'm trying to say, because it's going to be a little bit complicated to visualize what I'm about to explain. So try and listen carefully, and I'm going to try and choose my words as best as I can, because I've made this video a couple of times now. This is like my fourth take, and I want to make sure that my vocabulary is correct so that way you can understand the point that I'm trying to get across and I'm not confusing anybody. So the first part of the question, does boost jumping get somebody in an advantageous location? So is there an area in a map where boost jumping is the only way to access it, and that location is advantageous for a gunfight? You know, and the reason that this would make it a skill is because if you know about this location and you anticipate, you know, getting into a gunfight, you can boost jump into that advantageous location using your knowledge of the game, you know, game knowledge that you had to develop through play or through experience, and win gunfights in that way. And I personally can't think of any location in Black Ops 3 where you can only access via boost jumping that is also an advantageous place to be. Usually when people are boost jumping, and I would say 95% of the time or more that people are boost jumping to reach a location, they're boost jumping into a window or up a flight of stairs or something along those lines, to a location that is accessible without boost jumping. So in that way, boost jumping doesn't place the player in an advantageous location for any given period of time. You know, there's just no way that you could use boost jumping in combination with your environment to get you in a place that you would only know if you had the skill and knowledge to get there. So in that way, boost jumping again fails the test. The other part of that is, if boost jumping, and here's where it gets complicated, if boost jumping included an infinite hover perk that allowed you to stay in the air indefinitely, that would be skillful, but it doesn't do that. And let me explain why that makes such a big difference. So if you guys remember the hover ability from Advanced Warfare, you could boost jump, right, and hover there for a second or two, something along those lines. So imagine that exact scenario, but you could hover forever in a single location. If boost jumping worked that way, it would be a lot more skillful. And the reason for that is very similar to what we just talked about, in that it puts a player in an advantageous location that they had to only have gotten to through the knowledge that it would bring them into the advantageous spot of winning gunfights. So let me give you a little bit of an example of what I'm talking about, and let me try and make this make a little bit of sense to you. So let's say you see an enemy in front of you and you start chasing them, and they run through a door and disappear from your sight. So you as the player, and all of these things go through your mind without you actively thinking about it, right? It's just like muscle memory and you just do it when you play Call of Duty. But here's what actually happens. You know that that player ran through the door and they disappeared. And we're talking Black Ops 3 here. You approach the doorway, and in your brain, you think there is a 50% chance that they went left or a 50% chance that they went right. Obviously, if they went out of your sight of view, they're not straight through the doorway or else you would see them, so they're either off to the left or off to the right. However, you also have to take into account that boost jumping is in this game. So now there is a, let's say, 49% chance they're on the left and 49% chance that they're on the right. They could have gone either way, but now there is a 2% chance that they're in the air, and you have to think, you have to know that, right? You have to know that, hey, maybe they went through the door and you know, they went off to the right, but then they double jumped anticipating me going through the door, and you have to anticipate that. But because boost jumping is a temporary thing and you don't hover in the air when you boost jump, it's only, you know, a second that you jump through the air or less, the chances of them being in the air are only 2% or less. And I'm just making these numbers up, but you have to understand the concept here, right? The odds of them being in the air are far smaller than them being on the ground and towards the left or to the right. So in this scenario, you're going to run through the door and look either left or right. And the reason that you do that is because by looking left or right, there's a 98% chance that you're going to find your enemy. And, you know, again, I'm making these numbers up, but you cannot deny that the odds of them being on the ground somewhere are way higher than them being in the air, because you're on the ground most of the time in Black Ops 3. You're just, the game is, you move around with your legs, so you're on the ground most of the time. There's a small fraction of time that the character is actually in the air with a boost jump. So, in Black Ops 3, when you run through the door, you're not going to just look up in the small chance that they're up there. So the reason that the hover would make a difference is if you knew that they could be in the sky, right? Then you would know that you run through the door, there's a 25% chance that they're on the floor to the left, 25% chance they're on the floor to the right, and then you would take into account maybe there's a 25% chance that they're hovering off to the left or hovering off to the right. So in that way, it would make it logical for you to check all of those areas, because, you know, they could equally be anywhere on the screen in a three-dimensional space. The way that Black Ops 3 currently works, like I said, that people, characters, are only in the sky for a fraction of a second. So it's illogical to run through a door and just start looking around up, because odds are they're not there, because people are only there for a second when they boost jump. Because you can't counter boost jumping, and that's really what this is about. You cannot counter boost jumping through preparation or map knowledge. That it's just impossible. So in that way, boost jumping can't be countered with map knowledge, and boost jumping also isn't benefited through the use of map knowledge. The two points that I just covered proved that. You know, you can't go anywhere that you can't go with just boots on the ground. You know, there's no advantageous boost jumping locations that I can think of. And also, you can't counter the boost jump because it's illogical to just assume somebody would be in the sky at any given moment. The third thing that I want to talk about is the reason that actually adds a little bit of skill through boost jumping, and that is the timing of the boost jump. Boost jumping does take a little bit of skill in that you have to know when to boost jump. You know, if you're in a gunfight and you're gonna die and you know that a boost jump could save you, that's a little bit of skill. Like, yes, you can double jump and potentially save your life, and if you are an unskilled player, you may not have thought of that, so that is reasonable. It is a skill in that regard, in that the timing of the boost jump matters, and that's where the little bit of skill that I talked about before comes in. My counter to that, though, is that nobody thought the melee knife in previous Call of Duties was a skill. And the difference between the boost jumping winning you a gunfight and a knife winning you a gunfight is almost none. Think about it. If you are in a previous Call of Duty and you run into an enemy and they stab you, right? You don't say, oh, I outplayed, outskilled, man. They totally beat me. That was too much skill. No, you get fucking pissed because you tried to shoot them and you tried to engage them realistically, like you should in Call of Duty with a one-on-one gunfight, and they killed you with the press of a button. And that was not skill. It was a reaction. It was simply reaction time. His reaction time was better than yours, and reaction times are not trained skills. You know, some people just naturally have better reaction times, and you can increase your reaction time, but only to a certain level, and it will get worse with time, like with age, as you get older. Comparing that to Black Ops 3, if you run into somebody and they boost jump out of your line of sight, you can't see them and they can see you because they were the ones that planned the boost jump. So they are already looking down at you immediately. And in that way, it's a reaction thing. They just immediately boost jumped and they got the kill because they pressed a single button, which is the boost jump button. And in that way, it is very similar to the knife. Boost jumping does take a little bit more skill than the knife. And that's why at the beginning of this video, I did say it takes a little bit of skill, or it adds a little bit of skill to the game. And the reason for that is because when you do double jump, right? It is counterable at a distance. If you are in a medium to long range engagement, you can counter the boost jump if you can follow the player with your crosshairs. So it is different from the knife in that way, but not so different that I seriously do think they're very, very similar techniques. In both instances, you only press a single button when you react to the other player, and in both instances, that single button press can immediately give you the kill that you may not have gotten otherwise. So the two are a little bit different, and that's why boost jumping adds a little bit of skill to the game. I did talk about how it brings a lot of negatives though, and that it doesn't make it better just because there's boost jumping. You know, it does. You know, the added skill comes at a huge cost. The huge cost is the randomness that boost jumping brings to the game. If you're firing at somebody, even if you know that they could potentially boost jump, you can boost jump in all different kinds of directions, so you can't anticipate the boost jumping effectively. So they could go anywhere. They could go up to the left, up to the right, straight up and back, or whatever. So the fact that, you know, it adds a tiny bit of skill is completely countered by the fact that it adds this whole randomness of you not knowing how to counter it, because you can't train to counter a randomness. It's just completely random. And you know, obviously if there's a wall somewhere, then it decreases the amount of direction somebody can go to only 6 instead of 8 or something along those lines. So in that way, maybe, you know, there's a little bit of reasoning you could do to counter a boost jump. But in general, it's really random. And the additional randomness that it adds by flipping the spawns more frequently, and the reason that the spawns flip more frequently is because players are moving all over the map faster because they can get places quicker than before through boost sliding and boost jumping and wall running and all this kind of stuff. The game is more fast paced and the spawns are a little bit more random. So the randomness of the gunfights plus the randomness of the engagements, the actual engagements that you would get into, I think it just makes it unfair for players that can logically win games through map knowledge, skill, and things along those lines. You know, a lot of that goes out the window with boost jumping because of the fact that you can't counter randomness. You can't do that. The best player in the world can't counter randomness because randomness is inherently random. There's no one answer to randomness. Another point that I want to make is that if boost jumping actually added a skill that Call of Duty intentionally added, right? You know, they were thinking, people are just really good at Call of Duty. We need to add another thing that they have to get good at now in order to stay good at Call of Duty. The reason that boost jumping doesn't fall in that category is because the games have been getting more and more easy for new players to play. The entire business model of Call of Duty as of late has been catering to the newcomer, right? And the reason for that is because they want to sell more games. They want to introduce more people to the franchise so that way more people continue to buy the franchise's yearly, you know, installment. And that makes total sense. They're not going to accomplish that by adding another skill that makes it even harder for newcomers to learn, you know? So in that way, it's almost proof in itself that boost jumping is not a skill, because it doesn't make sense for the franchise that is trying to get more new players. If boost jumping were a skill, it would be harder for new players to join, but they clearly are making it easier for new players to join. So by that logic, boost jumping can't be both. You know what I'm saying? They wouldn't have added boost jumping if it added so much skill that new players would be turned off by this added dimension that all these other players are already getting used to, and they haven't even gotten used to the basics of Call of Duty. So with all that being said, hopefully you guys understand what I'm trying to say in this video. This video is definitely longer than my average upload, but it's a very complicated thing that I've tried to just put into words here. And I hope you understand what I'm saying, you know, and I know that there might be some people that like boost jumping who don't understand what I'm saying, and they might dislike the video or get mad at me in the comments, and I totally anticipate that, and that's totally fine. But if you do know, if you do understand where I'm coming from, right, and you have a logical counter for that, I would like to hear it in the comment section below. This is a actual debate that I would like to have. I would like to talk to you guys as to why you think boost jumping actually adds skill to the game. And I think I've presented my case pretty logically in this video. We talked about how anybody can boost jump. We talked about how it doesn't give a player an advantageous location because it doesn't get you to, you know, boost jump only locations, nor does it allow you to hover in the three-dimensional space. And we also talked about how it does add a little bit of random, or it does add a little bit of skill in the fact that you have to know when to boost jump, but the added randomness of the boost jump, it just makes it not worth it in most people's opinion, because of all the reasons that I stated in the beginning of the video about it, you know, making the game just the 1v1 gunfights more random. So hopefully you enjoy the video. Whether or not you enjoy boost jumping, make sure you leave a rating. I would really, really appreciate it. Again, comment down below your thoughts on the boost jump. Does it add skill to Call of Duty? I would really like to hear from you. I always respond to comments, so make sure you drop a comment down below. Subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos like this. I would love to see you around here more frequently, and I think you'll enjoy the other content on my channel, so make sure you give that a glance. And that's about it, guys. So thanks for watching. This has been Omniarch, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace.